Hi, I'm Dr. Greg Castello, board-certified family practice with CastelloWellness.com. I hope you've already watched my videos on the HCG diet explaining the science behind the diet. Today we're going to go ahead and talk about the nuts and bolts of actually starting the diet, and this is what you need to know. The diet is classically broken up into four separate phases. Phase one is the gorge diet. Phase two is the actual diet. Phase three is coming off of the medication. And phase four basically is the rest of your life. So phase one, the gorge diet portion, and I don't like the term gorge, but that's what's all over the internet in the book, so we're going to consistently use that term gorge diet. You start the diet on day one by taking an injection, and we want you to eat fat-containing foods. So for breakfast, have eggs and cheese. Don't have the juice or the toast. Lunchtime, maybe have a salad with vinegar and oil dressing and cheese and eggs, and put some avocado on there. Afternoon, if you're hungry, go ahead and eat nuts or seeds or peanut butter. Dinner, have a piece of fatty fish like salmon or porterhouse steak or ground chuck burger, something fat containing. I don't want you to eat when you're not hungry. I don't want you to go out at 11:45 at night and eat McDonald's because you've got 15 minutes left. You're not eating like you're going to the electric chair. You're just choosing fat containing foods. It seems counterintuitive to gain a pound or two at the beginning of the diet, but it really is essential. If you don't do that gorge phase, then you tend to stall out at about day 14. So you're eating fat containing foods. You're not eating massive amount of calories. You're not eating if you're not hungry. You probably won't actually eat a lot. Phase one is either 1 or 2 days, depending on how long you're planning to do the diet. If you are 300 pounds and you're doing the full 40 days, then absolutely do a full 2-day gorge. If you're doing less than that, 10 or 21 days, or you don't have that much to lose, then just do 1 gorge day. Phase two is you do your shots in the morning and you are actually on the low calorie portion of the diet. For a woman, this is generally 500 calories. For a man, it's about 800 calories. If you exercise, we let you add additional calories, or if you have a physical job like construction, you eat more calories. So a typical day is get up in the morning, take your shot. If you drink coffee, you can have coffee, but not with cream and sugar. So if you need to, you can get a little bit of unsweetened almond milk. You can put Splenda or Stevia in there as a sweetener. It may be easier just to do a sugar-free Monster or sugar-free Red Bull if you are caffeine dependent. You're generally not hungry, so you're not eating breakfast. Lunch is a lean protein source, so a grilled chicken breast on the George Foreman grill with lemon and salt and pepper. You can have shrimp or lobster, not dipped in butter. Egg whites are fine on the diet. A lean piece of white fish like tilapia or halibut are fine. With the lean protein source, you do 2 cups of vegetables, so fresh spinach, grilled asparagus, cherry tomatoes, squash. There's a list on the diet, and I'll give you a copy of what we hand out, and any of those vegetables are fine. In the afternoon, you eat a small apple or a handful of strawberries. Dinner time is another lean protein source, so chicken or fish or eggs or even tuna in water. 2 more cups of vegetables. In the evening, you get another small apple and a couple breadsticks or Melba toast. So that's the typical diet. If you exercise, ideally we have you exercise in the morning on an empty stomach with just your caffeine. You can have egg whites or a small protein source and vegetable to take up what you just burned off at the gym. If you go to the gym and you are dizzy or lightheaded or not doing what you normally can because you're tired, you're probably not getting enough calories. If you haven't started exercising yet, the diet is not the time to start training for a marathon, so stay in your normal activity level, and then when you're done with the actual diet, you can go ahead and introduce calories and introduce more exercise. So that's the end of phase two. The book says you should do 3 days where you do not do the shot, but you continue the low-calorie diet. If you're doing the full 40-day diet, that's okay. If you do less than 40 days, I usually don't have you do the low-calorie without the shot. You just stop the shots and go back to a fuller diet. Phase three is I'm done with the shots. I'm going back to more calories, but it's still carb restricted, so no bread, rice, pasta, or potatoes. Limit your sweets and sugar. You typically will lose about a pound a week if you do this low-carb diet. A South Beach diet would be a similar diet. Paleo diet or the Zone diet are all carb-controlled diets, which would be fine for phase three. You can stay in that for the rest of your life if you want to. You can take a 4 to 6 week break from HCG and then go back into a second round of HCG if you need to lose more weight. Phase four, which is not necessarily what you need to do, but phase four gradually introduces back carbohydrates in your diet. But that's a good way to gain weight is eating too much bread, rice, pasta, or potatoes. So if you're used to a lower carb diet, that's a great lifetime diet to stick to. A lot of people will stay on a version of the diet, just more calories, so they get used to not eating breakfast, which is fine. That's intermittent fasting. We've talked about that before. They have a lean protein source and vegetables for lunch. They don't have to measure how much they're eating. They can have two vegetables if they want to. They like that apple or berries as a snack, and dinner, again, a similar lean protein source and vegetables and avoiding the carbs. So next I'm going to cut away and show you how to actually draw up your dose of the medications. That's something that we'll do in the office before you start, but here's a good reference to how to draw up your medications. Thanks. Okay, so here's what you're going to get. You're going to get a vial of HCG that you keep in the refrigerator. It's got a pink tint to it because it comes mixed with B12 already, a bunch of syringes, and a bunch of alcohol wipes. So your daily routine is going to be to take your alcohol wipe and clean off the top of the bottle to make sure there's no bacteria on it. So you just take your fingertip and you twist it a couple of times. Make sure you get that rubber nice and wet with alcohol. Your syringes look like this. You want to take the back cover off of the syringe, take off your needle cap, and you want a bullseye right in the middle. Be careful if you get it stuck on the side, it gets stuck in the plastic. It's a tiny needle. You flip your vial over so the liquid is covering the tip of the needle, and then you slowly pull the medicine into the syringe, and you can see it's got a pink tint to it. That's the B12 that actually helps it draw up, so you can see it a little bit easier to make sure there's no air bubbles in there. Your dose is either going to be 15 or 20, which is 150 or 200 units. Typically, you'll pull the syringe back past where you need to be. If there's an air bubble in there, you can tap it and get the air bubble out, and then slowly push up so the top of the black rubber stopper is at the 20 mark if your dose is 20, or at the 15 mark if it's 15, and that's your dose of the medication. You take the bottle off and then you're ready to go. When you inject the medication, you clean off your belly with some alcohol, and you want to pinch the fat a little bit, and then your injection's going to go in between your fingers. You want to be sure to grab it like a dart. Don't grab on the back and plunge the liquid out before you get it into your skin, so hold it by the actual syringe and poke in like a dart. If you go slow, you can kind of feel it, so just a quick hi-ya. And once you're in, you don't have to pull back. You just push and inject the medication, and then you're done for the day. Okay, I hope that was helpful. If I just saw you in the office, this literally is what we just talked about, but hearing it a second time is helpful. The handouts are going to be helpful for you. Occasionally, you may need to delve into the book, but most people never really need to read the book. There is no wrong way to do it. The book is very rigid and very strict on what you do and doing the 40 days, and oftentimes 10 days on, 10 days off, or two 21-day cycles with a break in between are sufficient based on what your weight loss needs are and how you do on the diet. So as always, if you have questions on the diet, call me, please. Don't struggle. There's very simple fixes for some occasional roadblocks that people will have on the diet. Dr. Castello, thank you.